18 months after the destructive attack by General Zod using his army of greedy problems, Superman has become a controversial figure. His short-sighted approach in fighting with Zod, like always going for seemingly next best thing, optimizing the present without regard for the future, and never changing past choices, has landed him in troubles with Bruce Wayne. Lex Luthor, on the other hand, is orchestrating an army of new threats, with power greater than either of them, using a class of villains like LCS, Knapsack, and LIS. Will Batman and Superman be successful in resolving their internal conflict? How will they tackle Lex's army that endangers the world and can cause total destruction? All your questions will be answered in this section of Dynamic Programming, created as a part of Algorithm Course by Stanford Crowd Course Initiative. The scene is a flashback with Bruce and his family coming out of a lecture in Dynamic Programming. Little Bruce, having not understood a word, asks his mother to explain it in simple language. His mother writes this down on a sheet of paper. What's that equal to? Bruce counts and says, 8, it's 8. His mother then writes down another 1 plus on the left and says, what about that? 9. How did you come to know it was 9 so fast? You just added one more. So, you didn't need to recount because you remembered there were 8. Dynamic programming is just a fancy way to say remembering stuff to save time later. Delighted with the new addition in his knowledge base, Bruce registers this in his memory palace. But this happiness didn't last long, as the night ended in a tragedy. Bruce realized that the knowledge he attained was just the easy part. If he really wants to avoid such tragedy in future, he needs to learn exactly what to memorize and how to apply it. In the present, Mr. Wayne successfully infiltrates a fundraiser promoted by Luthor to retrieve data from LexCorp's mainframe, where he stores the details about his army. Wayne carefully studies the plethora of information on Lex's conspiracy and finds two major patterns that constitute his army. The first is optimal substructure. A problem is said to exhibit optimal substructure if an optimal solution to the problem contains within it an optimal structure to its subproblem. As an example, Wayne recalls the night he traveled from Gotham to Metropolis. If a city X lies in the shortest path from Gotham to Metropolis, then the shortest path between them is a combination of shortest path from Gotham to X and the shortest path from X to Metropolis. But to his dismay, determining the longest path didn't exhibit this optimal substructure property. He refers to the CLRS book to get the following unweighted graph. Here, there are two longest paths from Q to T, QRT and QST. But the longest path QRT is not a combination of longest path from Q to R and the longest path from R to T, because the longest path from Q to R is QSTR. That's new, Bruce exclaimed. The second is the pattern of overlapping subproblems. A problem is said to exhibit this pattern if it can be broken down into smaller subproblems, which are further divided into still smaller ones, and in this process, one observes some overlapping. Armed with this information, Bruce Wayne dons his mask and cape to right Superman's wrongs. Superman, on the other hand, is summoned to a congressional hearing at the US Capitol to debate the validity of his actions. The hearing ends with him taking an oath of saving people in a Fibonacci fashion. That is, the number of people he saves in his nth attempt is the sum of number of people he saved in his previous two attempts. While calculating the number of people he needs to save in his sixth attempt, he computes fib of 4 twice, fib of 1 thrice, and fib of 2 5 times. Phew, that's a lot of repeating stuff. He sighs, I might even run out of time if I go out to save people on my 50th attempt. Engaged in his thoughts, Superman receives a message from Luthor to meet him up at the Daily Planet Tower. Luthor blackmails Superman into confronting Batman by holding his adoptive mother Martha Kent hostage. Batman, while waiting in his enhanced armor, instigates a fight with Superman and ultimately gains an upper hand. Before Batman can kill Superman with his kryptonite spear, Superman urges Batman to save Martha. Hearing these words, Batman's mind races up to the night his mother Martha was killed. Batman recollects the note he left in his memory palace at that time. Dynamic programming! Batman's eyes light up in an epiphany. He realized the key to defeat Lex's army. Together with Superman's experience with overlapping subproblem and Batman's expertise with optimal substructure, they devise two methods to tackle Lex's troops. The first is the top-down method. We start solving the given problem by breaking it down. If we see that the problem has been solved already, then just return the saved answer. If not, then solve it and save the answer. Superman tries to compute his Fibonacci problem using this approach and comes out with the following pseudocode. He creates a map between two integers and maps 0 to 0 and 1 to 1. He then passes n to a function and checks if map exists for n or not. If not, he maps n to sum of fib n minus 1 and fib n minus 2. At this step, he is breaking the problem down and storing the information in a map. If map exists for n, then just return the value. Now I won't run out of time when I go out to save people on my 50th attempt. Thanks, Superman. The second method they devise is the bottom-up method. Here, we analyze the problem and see the order in which the subproblems are solved. Then we start solving from the most trivial subproblem up towards the given problem. In this process, it is guaranteed that all the subproblems are solved before reaching the given problem. Superman again tries to solve his Fibonacci problem using this approach and comes up with the following pseudocode. In a function that takes n as a parameter, he declares a variable m and allocates n plus 1 memory units to it. He stores 0 at the 0th position and 1 at the first position. He then loops from 2 to n and in each loop stores the sum of mi minus 1 and mi minus 2 at m of I. Thus, we see that he has ordered his subproblems and is solving them from the most trivial one up towards the given problem. Finally, he returns the last element of his allocated memory. It now seems that our heroes have found the kryptonite of Lex's army of supervillains as they head towards his base of operations. The first bad guy our heroes need to defeat is the longest common subsequence. The problem is, given two subsequences, find the length of longest subsequence present in both of them. A subsequence is a sequence that appears in the same relative order but not necessarily contiguous. For example, LCS for input sequences APCDGH and AEDFHR is ADH. At a blink of an eye, Superman unleashes his brute strength at the supervillain. He generates all the subsequences of both given strings and loops through them to find the longest matching subsequence. He soon realizes that this will take him time of the order of 2 to the power n. Thus, he calms down, takes a deep breath, and starts to think for a better approach to this problem. While Superman was battling LCS with all his might, Batman was thinking of a recursive solution to the problem. He comes out with the following approach. If last characters of both the sequences match, then LCS of x and y is 1 plus LCS of x minus the last character and y minus the last character. On the other hand, if the last characters of both the sequences do not match, then LCS of x and y is maximum of LCS of x minus last character and y and LCS of y minus last character and x. Batman knew that LCS has an optimal substructure property, as it is visible that the main problem can be solved using optimal solutions to its subproblems. Batman passed this information to Superman. To get a better picture, Superman started to draw the recursive tree structure of two sample strings. He reached only the second level when he observed the first overlapping subproblem. Our heroes instantly understood what they were supposed to do next. With fire in their eyes, they took position to unleash the ultimate weapon in their arsenal, dynamic programming. Our heroes decide to tackle this enemy with a bottom-up approach. Now that they know the calculations they need to do, they next pick the best order to do them in. The pseudocode they come up with first creates a 2D array of size n plus 1 by n plus 1, and they loop through this array in a column-wise fashion. The first condition initializes the 0th row and the 0th column with 0. Depending on whether the previous character of the strings are equal or not, they decide to add 1 to li minus 1 j minus 1 or to take maximum of li minus 1 j and li j minus 1. Finally, they return the last element. The complexity of this implementation is of the order of m into n, as they are technically just filling a table of size m plus 1 by n plus 1 with each cell taking a unit computation time. This computes only the length of the LCS. For printing the LCS, they need to traverse the 2D array from the last element and check if the characters in x and y corresponding to lij are same or not. If they are, then they include this character as a part of the LCS. Else, they compare the values of li minus 1j and li j minus 1 and go in the direction of the greater value. The table for two sample strings is shown here. So now onwards, whenever you face a problem in dynamic programming, just think of what Superman and Batman would do. And that concludes our video. This course was created as a part of the Stanford Crowd Course Initiative, the world's first massive online open coursework developed entirely by an online community. If you would like to learn more about us or view more of our courses, visit crowdcourse.stanford.edu.